ay, ay. I cannot finish my work because my computer will not charge. I have no idea what to do. My husband always says, ask Charles, who is Granada's wonderful tech guy.
That's true. Hey, boys and girls, can you think of a time you weren't able to do something and needed help from someone else? Just like we need help here? Such as opening a pickle jar, or carrying a heavy box.
Or fixing a computer.
Right. We may not be strong enough to complete the task, or we may not know enough to complete the task. Now, were you quick to ask for help, or did you try hard to finish it by yourself? And also, who did you ask to help you?
Well, today we're going to hear about something that no one could do. No one except for one special person. Ooh. So let's find out today what that thing is and who could do it here
at Granadakids.
Do you know what a throne is? Have you ever seen a real throne in person?
Perhaps you've seen one like the kind Santa sits on in December.
True.
But boys and girls, who usually sits on a throne?
A king or a queen, of course.
That's right.
That is where they sit to hear the requests of their people and to determine how best to meet their needs.
Wonderful. Now, take a minute to think about what you would see in a throne room. Could you imagine one? How pretty would it be? What items or other people would be there? Please let us know. Share your ideas with the teacher and with your friends.
Today, we will hear about a throne room that is greater than anything we can imagine, truly. And we are going to hear what and who is there.
How exciting, Miss Sandy. I can't wait.
Amazing.
I love to sing. Do you? I sing when I go about my day doing all kinds of activities. Do you like to listen to music? Well, it's important to listen to the words when you hear a song, right? Well, for instance, I love the song, "He's got the whole world in his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands." Now here's a little listening activity for you. Let's listen to one of my favorite praise songs. Grab a paper and some crayons, listen carefully to the words, and draw what you feel or hear. This can be a time of quiet praise for you too. And feel free to share your picture when you are done. Let's get started. You know, you can do this on your own too. Listening and singing worship songs gives us a chance to praise and worship Jesus. When we listen to and sing truths about Jesus that praises him and what he has done for us, you know, in today's Bible story, we will learn about one day when all creatures will worship Jesus. Can you imagine what that would be like? Let's find out.
Good morning, Granadakids. I'm Mr. Greg. As we look more at the book of Revelation, let's remember our big picture question and answer. Let's say them. What is the hope of the church? The church looks forward to Jesus' return when he will make all things new. No matter how difficult, scary, or uncertain our lives may feel sometimes, we can trust that God's plans for the future are perfect and inevitable. Inevitable, that's a big word. Do you know what it means? It means that God's plans are definitely 100% absolutely going to happen someday. That is good news, and that truth is why believers have hope, no matter what. Let's listen to more of what this last book in the Bible says.
John was on the island of Patmos when he had a vision. Jesus appeared to John and showed him what will happen before the end of time. John wrote about what he saw in the book of Revelation. John saw a throne in heaven and someone sitting on it. The one seated looked like fiery red stones. A rainbow like an emerald surrounded the throne. He saw 24 thrones around it, and 24 elders sat on the thrones. Each elder wore a gold crown. John saw four living creatures around the throne. The first creature was like a lion. The second was like an ox. The third creature had a face like a man. And the fourth creature was like a flying eagle. Each creature had six wings. All day and night, they said, "Holy, holy, holy, Lord God, the Almighty, who was, who is, and who is coming." John saw the creatures give glory, honor, and thanks to the one on the throne. The elders fell down and worshiped. They said to God, "You are worthy to receive glory and honor and power because you have created all things." Then John saw a scroll in the right hand of the one seated on the throne. A mighty angel asked, "Who is worthy to open the scroll?" No one in heaven was worthy. No one on earth was worthy. No one under the earth was worthy either. John began to cry loudly because no one was worthy. At last, one of the elders said, "Look, the Lion of Judah may open the scroll. He is worthy." Then John saw someone near the throne. He was standing like a slaughtered lamb. He took the scroll, and the elders and the living creatures fell down before Jesus, the Lamb. The elders threw their crowns at his feet. They worshiped him and sang a new song. John heard thousands and thousands of angels around the throne. They said in a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slaughtered to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing." John heard every creature everywhere, in heaven, on earth, under the earth, and on the sea, worshiping the Lamb together. John cried when he saw that no one was worthy to open the scroll. Then John saw the resurrected Lamb, God's Son, Jesus. Jesus was killed on the cross so that we could have forgiveness and eternal life. Jesus is worthy. He deserves all praise, honor, and blessing.
Let's talk for a minute about adjectives. Do you know what an adjective is? An adjective is a word that describes something or someone, and there are three in today's lesson. First of all, holy. Holy is a powerful word that means Jesus is set apart from everything and everyone else, and he has a special purpose to be our perfect sacrifice and Lord. Number two is almighty. There is nothing our God cannot do. And number three is worthy. The Bible says the angel said with a loud voice that Jesus, the Lamb of God, is worthy to receive all power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise. Only he is worthy of our worship. We pray that you will not only worship him with your words and in song, but with your whole lives as you follow him.
Good morning, Granadakids. I'm Miss Deanne. Revelation has many passages that are not perfectly clear, but John's vision shows us what will happen in the future. We can be certain that Jesus will return. We don't know exactly when Jesus will make everything right, but we can be sure that he will reign over all the world for eternity. Now let's say our key passage together. The kingdom of the world has become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ, and he will reign forever and ever. Revelation 11:15. Because only Jesus has lived a perfect life, taken the sin of the world to the cross, and risen from the dead, only he is worthy to reign forever. All people and creatures will worship Jesus. One day, every president, every king, every ruler, every person will worship Jesus. He is the King of Kings. Let's praise him together in song.
Hi, I'm Troy.
Hi, I'm Jesse. Please bow your head and pray with us.
Lord God, thank you for sending Jesus to take the punishment for our sin and to rule victoriously over sin and death. You are worthy to be praised. Help us share the hope and joy you offer so that others can join with us as we worship you around your throne forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Have you ever spoken a different language? Here in Miami, we can hear many different languages, including English and Spanish and Portuguese. Now, did you know that we worship God in all three of these different languages at Granada? Yep, that's right. But this morning, let's try to worship God in a completely different language. How about Swahili? Swahili is the official language of Uganda. I've never spoken it before, but let's give it a try. The Bible says that one day all people and creatures will worship Jesus together. Yes and amen. People from every tongue, tribe, and nation. So let's learn three expressions of worship in the Swahili language. Let's get started. It is you to be worshipped. Let's say that together. Niwewe wakua budiwa. Niwewe wakua budiwa. Good job. Now let's say this one. You are the one to be given praise and glory and honor. Wakupe wasifwa na u tukufu nahai she maniwewe. Let's say that again. Wakupe wasifwa na u tukufu nahai she maniwewe. Wow, that's a long one. And last but not least, you are the one who is strong and powerful. Yes, he is. Mwe ne guvu na u weza ni wewe. Congratulations, you did it. It's going to be amazing to hear Jesus being honored and glorified by this beautiful worship in so many languages. What a celebration.
So, one day, all people and creatures will worship Jesus together. People from every tongue, tribe, and nation. Jesus will be honored and glorified, boys and girls. Only he is worthy to open that scroll. John saw that Jesus was the only one worthy. Jesus deserves all praise, honor, and blessing. One day, all of us and all creatures will join together to worship Jesus forever and ever. So let us worship Jesus now, together, as we wait for his return. While we worship Jesus, let us have hope and anticipation and excitement for the day we will join all believers and creatures in praise and worship of Jesus in heaven. Join the party today, boys and girls. Profess your faith in Jesus. Trust and obey him and his ways today.